honor.
Honor.
Give him the glory forever.
Give him glory forever.
Give him power.
Power.
And dominion.
And dominion.
All this and more
are his.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations.
We praise thee, O God, our Redeemer, Creator, in grateful devotion our tribute we bring. We lay it before thee, we kneel and adore thee, we bless thy holy name, glad praises we sing.
With voices united, our praises we offer to thee, great Jehovah, glad anthems we raise. Thy strong arm will guide us, our God is beside us. To thee, our great Redeemer, forever.
His life and not all meant for sin.
Would you join me in thanksgiving, worship, and praise? Would you pray with me? Heavenly Father, we would borrow the words of the psalmist David when he said, I will sing unto the Lord because he hath dealt bountifully with me. Your gifts to us are endless. They come in response to our request and often before we even ask. But our hearts are lifted to you now, not because of your generous provision, but because you are our Father God. We are your family. We don't ask you for anything right now. We don't really need anything. We just like to worship you. We join the angels in heaven and our brothers and sisters around the world in one great chorus of praise. This praise shall not remain only in our hearts. It will flow forth from our lips. In Jesus' name, amen.
Things you have done for me, things so undeserved, yet you give to prove your love to me. The voices of a million angels could not express
God's bountiful goodness is endless. Trees, mountains, the sky and the sea. There's beauty everywhere. the sunrise of a new day, the sunset just before dark, air to breathe, water to cleanse, food to eat, friends to love, work to do, and then rest from that labor. A smile because of happiness, a tear because of feelings too deep to express any other way, fear that protects, and trust that brings a calm. Only the most ungrateful could miss God's bountiful goodness. Perhaps, though, our praise and our thankfulness is all too often dependent on the amount, kind, or timing of God's apparent goodness to us. Our relationship need not be based on what He does or does not do at any given moment, but upon His nature and upon His utter dependability. Our thanksgiving and praise should not be the result of things God does for us or gives to us. It should be for who He is and what He is. He is Father God, and we are His family, heirs of God, joint heirs with Jesus Christ. So, in Festival of Praise, we lift our praise to God for Himself, Jesus, the Holy Spirit, His Church, His Word, and Jesus' Second Coming. When we praise Him, He absolutely loves to make His entire resources available to us, and they are more than exceeding, abundant above all that we can ask or think. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Jesus is God's Son. John in his Gospel wrote, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son." Without Jesus, I couldn't be a part of the family of God. I even love his name, Jesus. The angel said to Joseph, "Thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins."
Thank you. London. And I'm now turned 80 years of age, so I have been around a long time. And I've seen many things. During the First World War, my parents' home was bombed, came completely demolished. And then in the Second World War, when I was married, our home was bombed, and our church was bombed. But during these times, we knew what it was to look to God for our health, our help, our strength. And I'm so glad that I'm able to say these things because of the sorrow that was all around us. But the people who know the Lord know where to turn for their comfort and their consolation. And so I, with them, have had many tears and sorrows. I've had questions about tomorrow. There were some times when I did not know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave blessed consolation that these trials only came to make me strong. And through it all, yes, through it all, I learned to trust in Jesus. I have learned to trust in God. Through it all, yes, through it all, I have learned to depend upon His Word.
Jesus, so how sweet the name. Praise him on the high sounding cymbals. Praise the Lord.
Is also a gift of God to us. The Holy Spirit's work continues every moment of every day, and His presence is cause for rejoicing and praise.
Come in Thy strength and Thy power. Come in Thy own gentle way.
Like a spring in the desert, come to the withered of soul. Oh, let Thy sweet healing power touch me and make me whole.
Thank you.
For the next few minutes, let's worship together. Would you just sing along with us?
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. He answers prayer. He answers prayer. He answers prayer. He's so good to me. Coming again.
One for all the brothers.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, there's joy in the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, there's joy in the Lord.
All the sisters now.
The Lord in heaven, the praises of the speaker. Let's just praise Him.
Of His people. Let's just praise Him. Oh, let's just praise Him. The Lord inhabits the praises of His people. So let's just praise the Lord.
Now let's sing the words of the psalmist.
I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue.
Everybody now.
I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will bless the Lord.
Let's praise the name of Jesus.
Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. He's my rock. He's my fortress. He's my deliverer. In Him will I trust. Praise the name of Jesus.
Together now.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
do, but I just came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. I don't know what you came to do, but I came to praise the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I just came from the dear old saint, and she was a praising the Lord. I just came from the dear old saint, and she was a praising the Lord. I just came from the dear old saint, and she was praising the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Saints.
God has always had a people. There have been times of affluence and prosperity when the church's message has been nearly diluted into oblivion by those who sought to make it socially attractive, neatly organized, and financially profitable. It has been gold-plated, draped in purple and encrusted with jewels. It has been misrepresented, ridiculed, lauded, and scorned. These followers of Jesus Christ have been, according to the whim of the times, elevated as sacred leaders and martyred as heretics. Yet through it all, there marches on that powerful army of the meek, God's chosen people who cannot be bought, flattered, murdered, or stilled. On through the ages they march, the church, God's church triumphant, alive and well.
Let the church be the church. Let the people rejoice, for we settle the question.
Discouraged pastor, it's God's church, and it's alive. Lonely missionary, sow the seed with confidence. It's alive. It's alive, my brokenhearted friend. Oh, saints, you're not alone and forgotten. The church is still alive. Busy mothers, cast all your cares on Jesus. It's alive, young student. You're not alone in serving the Lord. Faithful fathers, there's rest in the Lord. Cynical skeptic, you haven't killed God with your noisy unbelief. He's alive. So family of God, lift up your voices and praise the Lord. God's church is still alive and doing very well.
What a thrilling thing it is that we can be a part of the church. God's church is not bound by denominational barriers. It includes every person who has become a part of God's family through faith in Christ. But you know, there is yet another reason why our praise is lifted to God. He did not want us to try to find our way along the road of life by trial and error. He gave us His Word. He told us true stories about people who responded in faith to Him. We can positively depend upon the reliability of His promises.
Thy word, O God, is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path.
There was three children from the land of Israel, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. They took a trip to the land of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
Nebuchadnezzar was the king of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
He took a lot of gold and he made an idol for Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
And he told everybody when they hear the music of the cornet,
the flute,
and the harp, you must fall down and worship the idol, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
Wouldn't bow down, wouldn't bow down and worship. Couldn't fool them with the golden idol.
Well, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. Story short, it was a happy ending. The Lord's good name won out.
Your word, O God, shows your power again and again.
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down.
If only then.
it won't be long. Then we'll be leaving here. It won't be long. We'll be going home. It won't be long.
Then we'll be leaving.
Also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. God's clock is ticking, and soon Jesus is coming back again. That's why Paul said, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord." Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him just as he is.
We shall be like him. We shall
Jesus gathered his disciples together and tried to tell them how to talk to God in a very special way. He told them to approach God as Father, a Father who wanted to bless and give in abundance, a Father who would forgive every transgression, a Father who would not allow temptation to be greater than the escape, a Father God with kingdom and power and glory, not for any short space of time, but forever and ever and ever.
Our transgressions.